Hi folks, Lance from Runtime Recruitment. Now that we're all in lockdown, I thought I'd bring out some of these single board computers that I have lying around. I've got quite a number of them. This is a Raspberry Pi 3. I've got some boards from Hardkernel. They do these range of Odroid boards, and I've got a number of those. They're more powerful than the Raspberry Pi, and I've also got a Raspberry Pi Zero. Now I'm going to show you those in a little bit later on. And so what are we going to do with these? I mean, there's lots of different projects that you can do with these. I'm going to explore some of those today and perhaps get your thoughts on maybe using some of these single board computers. And perhaps you guys have played around with them. I mean, there's a million and one videos out there on the internet, on YouTube, with people, you know, building all sorts of things with these. So I thought I'd make a little video to sort of get your, you know, creativity flowing as well. And maybe you guys have built something very interesting. I mean, these things can be used for all sorts of things, home automation, they can be used as media servers. They can be used to host your website. You can create a NAS with them. You can even do computer vision if you wanted to with these things. They're powerful enough, some of them. Anyway, the Odroid range is more powerful than this. And Raspberry Pi has just brought out a new one, Raspberry Pi 4, which is even more powerful than the Raspberry Pi 3. So I just thought I'd put a little video together and get your thoughts. Put your comments in the field down there. Let me know what your thoughts are and, you know, what your experiences are. If you've actually had one of these and you've played with them, or you've had other single board computers. I've also got the Udo x86 board, which I'm using as a media server. I'm using it using a program called MB. And I'm actually built a media server where I basically put all my movies on there. And I can stream them across to my TV. This is my dog, Bella. She's sitting there chilling out with me while I'm doing all my work, doing all my little videos, playing around with my boards. She's great. She's absolutely fantastic.
Zero doubly tiny little board, as you can see. Four. This is a beast. This has 8 cores. It's really, really powerful. This is the Odroid C2.
So I showed you those SBCs. So what are you going to do with those single board computers? And there's a lot you can do with them. Look, there's if you're into home automation, there's a program called Home Assistant. This is open source. It's pretty good. And it's got a very, very big community. So if you're into that, you can basically download. There's lots of information on here how to get it started. There's even a demo. You can download the image for your Raspberry Pi or your Odroid, burn it to a flash disk, and off you go. It's very, very simple. If you don't want to have online storage out on the internet, you can actually have your local Dropbox right in your own home, and you can run it on a PC, or you can run it on one of these Odroids or one of these Raspberry Pis. So there's a program called Own Cloud. It's an open source software. You can actually, again, get the image, or you can actually just run up a distribution like I have, Diet Pi, and just install it, which is available there in the installation section. And have a go at that, and you can basically have your own Dropbox or Google Drive in your local network. Now, if you're into NASes, this is a really, really good piece of software. It's called Open Media Vault. It gives you a lot of functionality when it comes to building a NAS. And again, you can build that NAS on a Raspberry Pi, although it's a little bit low spec, the Raspberry Pi, for a NAS. But the Odroid, the UX4 Odroid, is quite powerful and maybe sufficient. And also Hardkernel does a dedicated development board, and it's a single board computer where it's been specifically made for network attached storage. So have a look at that. It's plenty to play with. Now, and this is what I've done with my Odroids. I'm running a couple of Odroids here instead of the Raspberry Pi. The reason is that the Odroid C2, they're very powerful. I'm using one as a general purpose server. I'm going to play around with that. You can load all sorts of applications on it. And I'm running one as a web server. So this is my web server, and I'm actually just SSHing into it. It's also got FTP, so I can download files to it or upload files to it. It's very, very quick, very easy. It's connected to the internet by a Wi-Fi connection and over my router. This is a really, really good distribution. And when it boots up, when you log into it remotely, like I SSH into it, you can run this program here, which is Diet Pi software. And if I run that script, it'll show you here, it'll give you the option to, what they've done is they've optimized some of the common packages out there, and they've made them available to you for easy installation using this interface. So if I just push this, you can actually see that, you know, there's a lot of different applications that are packaged here. You can You can actually load up a desktop if you wanted to. Diet Pi doesn't come with a desktop. It's normally command line. But if you wanted to run it as a desktop, you can actually download and install one of these desktop environments. You got Mate, you got XDE, you got XFE as well if you wanted it. And you've even got GNU Step if you want to play around with OpenStep as well. It's also got Chromium as well if you want to play around with that, and so on. Lots of different options. And down at the bottom there, you've got cloud and backup. So you can do backups. You can have a backup server as well, which does a full backup of your server, which is handy. And then it's got some hardware projects. If you're doing some interfacing with some of these SBCs, you can actually download some of these packages to allow you to interface with hardware. And of course, it's got the full web server stack, so you can pick whichever you want. You can pick the LAMP or the LASF stack, and all of these as well. They use different types of web servers. Home automation. Remember I was telling you about Home Assistant? You can actually download it here and install it from here, and it's very, very easy. And then you just, once you've selected, you just push the space bar and select it. I won't select that one, and say okay, and it will basically put it into the cache. And then you can actually go down to here and say install, and it will install the package. And then you have to reboot to actually get the package to work on the distribution. So it's very, very simple. I highly recommend you have a play with Diet Pi. Have some fun with this and let me know what your thoughts are on this in the comments field. See you in the next one. Cheers.